Triamterene is a potassium-sparing diuretic used in the treatment of edema and in the management of hypertension. In this video, let's find found. What is triamterene? What is triamterene used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking triamterene? How does triamterene work? How to use triamterene? What is triamterene? Triamterene is a potassium-sparing diuretic often used in combination with thiazide diuretics for the treatment of high blood pressure or swelling. The combination with hydrochlorothiazide is known as hydrochlorothiazide/triamterene. What is triamterene used for? Triamterene is indicated for the treatment of edema associated with congestive heart failure, cirrhosis of the liver, and the nephrotic syndrome, also in steroid-induced edema, idiopathic edema, and edema due to secondary hyperaldosteronism. Triamterene in combination with hydrochlorothiazide is indicated for the management of hypertension or treatment of edema in patients who develop hypokalemia following hydrochlorothiazide monotherapy, and in patients who require thiazide diuretic and in whom the development of hypokalemia cannot be risked. Triamterene allows the maintenance of potassium balance when given in combination with loop diuretics and thiazide. Contraindication. Contraindications include hyperkalemia, pregnancy, severe hepatic impairment, severe renal impairment, metabolic or respiratory acidosis, acute myopia, and secondary angle closure glaucoma. Side effects. Common side effects may include a depletion of sodium, folic acid, and calcium, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, headache, dizziness, fatigue, and dry mouth. Serious side effects may include heart palpitations, tingling/numbness, fever, chills, sore throat, rash, and back pain. Triamterene can also cause kidney stones through direct crystallization or by seeding calcium oxalate stones. Triamterene is best avoided in patients with chronic kidney disease due to the possibility of hyperkalemia. People using this drug should use salt substitute cautiously. Pharmacodynamic. Triamterene, a relatively weak, potassium-sparing diuretic and antihypertensive, is used in the management of hypertension and edema. It primarily works on the distal nephron and the kidneys. It acts from the late distal tubule to the collecting duct to inhibit Na plus reabsorption and decrease K plus excretion. As triamterene tends to conserve potassium more strongly than promoting Na plus excretion, it can cause an increase in serum potassium, which may result in hyperkalemia potentially associated with cardiac irregularities. In healthy volunteers administered with oral triamterene, there was an increase in the clearance of sodium and magnesium, and a decrease in the clearance of uric acid and creatinine due to its effect of reducing glomerular filtration renal plasma flow. Triamterene does not affect calcium excretion. In clinical trials, the use of triamterene in combination with hydrochlorothiazide resulted in enhanced pressure-lowering effects of hydrochlorothiazide. Mechanism of action. Triamterene inhibits the epithelial sodium channels, ANSE, located on the luminal side in the late distal convoluted tubule and collecting tubule, which are transmembrane channels that normally promote sodium uptake and potassium secretion. In the late distal tubule to the collecting duct, sodium ions are actively reabsorbed via ANSE on the luminal membrane and are extruded out of the cell into the peritubular medium by a sodium-potassium exchange pump, the Na ATPase, with water following passively. Triamterene exerts a diuretic effect on the distal renal tubule to inhibit the reabsorption of sodium ions in exchange for potassium and hydrogen ions, and its natriuretic activity is limited by the amount of sodium reaching its site of action. Its action is antagonistic to that of adrenal mineralocorticoids, such as aldosterone, but it is not an inhibitor or antagonist of aldosterone. Triamterene maintains or increases sodium secretion, thereby increasing the excretion of water and reducing the excess loss of potassium, hydrogen, and chloride ions by inhibiting the distal tubular exchange mechanism. Due to its diuretic effect, triamterene rapidly and reversibly reduces the lumen-negative transepithelial potential difference by almost completely abolishing Na+ conductance without altering K+ conductance. This reduces the driving force for potassium movement into the tubular lumen and thus decreases potassium excretion. Triamterene is similar in action to amiloride but, unlike amiloride, increases the urinary excretion of magnesium. Half-life. The half-life of the drug in plasma ranges from 1.5 to 2 hours. In a pharmacokinetic study involving healthy volunteers, the terminal half-lives for triamterene and 4-hydroxytriamterene sulfate were 255 plus or minus 42 and 188 plus or minus 70 minutes, respectively, after intravenous infusion of the parent drug. Dose. Edema. 100 to 300 mg/day PO Q day or divided Q12 HR. Hypertension, off-label. 50 to 100 mg PO Q day or divided Q12 HR. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans. But potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about triamterene we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.